Ooh, that seems awfully bright. More mail. Oops. Way too sharp. Ooh, but that might be actually what I want. Okay, we'll go with that. That's less overwhelmingly bright. Okay, so yeah, we already got that one. Oops, not the button I wanted to start with. But we are back to another done. Get rid of that. Okay. I'm home. It's 9 o'clock. I don't feel like playing any other games, so I decided to actually play on Saturday, even though I'm later than I would start. But I played yesterday, so we'll just play, and from here on out, Saturday night will be Gale night. Hi, Gale. My Derplander. So last time we left off with, let me turn that down a little bit, just kind of getting started here with Gale Fairheart. We have been mostly doing side quests around Noscea in middle and lower Noscea, the upper half of lower Noscea. I think we're only at maybe the level 8 MSQ quest. Nope, we're still at level 5, even though we're all the way up to a level 11 already. And so we're just going to keep going, and I'm doing both side quests and main story quests, because side quests can just add part of that immersion storyline, give us more of the backstory, more of the lore. And some of those side quest characters can reappear, and it just adds that much more to the story when you know who that person was when they come back. Remember when you helped me by fetching my lambs? And you can go, no, because I never did. But now we can go, yes. Yes, we did. So we will pick up where we left off, kind of cleaning up some of these side quests here by Red Rooster Stead. So far in our story, I don't know why somebody's around here casted something that we just zoomed or something. So far, Gale has just arrived in Limsilinosa and has registered in the Adventurers Guild. He has also registered at the Marauders Guild to gain skills in axe wielding. And all we really know what's going on so far is there are some kidnappings going on that we don't know too much about. This land is full of pirates, so there's always sketchy things going down. And we've also been having some trouble with kobolds. More mail. Trouble with kobolds in the area. Apparently there was a peace between the kobolds and the Lenosians and the pirates. And the more non-beast tribes. And apparently the Linosian or the Limsonians feel like they want more land, and so screw the truce, we're screwing over the kobolds, and damn the kobolds for getting upset about it and trying to screw us back. So that's kind of where we left off. So I will continue on my way here. Oh look, there's a Moogle right there. I know there's a few settings I wanted to check. Why do I keep getting like an echo call? What is that? I don't know. But okay, you know what? I'm gonna get rid of my minion, because I don't know if Kane, you're the one doing that. Or if there's somebody up top casting something. Why am I getting... That's just... Let me go up here. Does it follow me? Or is it in that area? Somebody looks like they're attacking striking dummies. Are you a red mage casting spells that are causing blur radiuses? You may be the culprit, perhaps, as I don't seem to be getting, or maybe it's just the Moogle going, hey, you have mail! Blur radius, blur radius, blur radius. Alright, let's hop back down here. Oh, and our storyline thus far as a marauder is as we're out just breaking stones with our axe, we came across and saved a boy from some megalocrabs, and apparently an aurochs killed his parents, so we're going to get revenge on that aurochs, but we're not strong enough yet. And so we have to keep building our strength so we can defeat this aurochs. And I'm never going to use the fantasias. Don't mind that noise. Okay, there we go. And we have an incoming cat. Leia, I can't see again. And you don't want those. No, I didn't think so. I didn't think so. Please don't pull your hair out. You don't need to be doing that. I will move this costume jewelry, though, so you can sit on that blanket. Ugh. Okay, and there were a couple things. Hi, Nim. Would you two be nice? One moment. Good girl, Nim. Good girl, Leia. Leia. She's not doing anything. Leia. Don't bully her. Nim's not doing anything. She's just sitting there being submissive. You can go about your business. Leia. 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 Stop staring her down. Leave her alone. Hey. Do I need to break you two up? Okay, that's it. That's it. We're separating. Who wants to leave the room? One person's getting out of the room. Leia, you're the attacking one. You can get out of the room. Nim, you get time with me. Okay. Now that... that's handled for now. Let me go back to what these things were. Accessibility, pictures, theme, you know. No. Okay, I think everything I need is in character config. General. Only when moving, yes. Now, what I want to know is where I can turn off getting the game prompt every time I log in, but I think that's less important. This is just that. HUD. Display fine text, size, parameters, XP, inventory duty. Oh, turn that off. We don't want that. Okay, maybe this is what I want to turn off. No. No. Okay. Now let's go ahead and do some stuff. Anything I need to pick up in here exactly? No. Okay. Oh, but wait, let me clear out that inventory. And where did Nim decide to hang out? Okay, good. Okay, good. Oops, that's in my way. Howdy there, fellow marauder. All right. Not gonna need that. Is that better than I currently have? No. Strength and dexterity, level 8. 15, 12. Tenacity, use, Use. Put in my armory chest. Use. I got so many minions from doing this. Use. I don't have a chocobo yet, but I have some barding. Use. Behemoth. Oh, it's the black mage barding. That's where I got that. Really don't care about the cascader uniforms because Gale is not going to be dressing up in bikinis. That looked like me. There's a lot of me's in this. Why did I... This server must be the place for Dirtlanders. Interesting. Right now I'm just doing errands for the local farmers because all the pirates are too lazy to do the actual work themselves. So I'll do it because I don't have a name for myself yet. I'm not anybody special. I'm just somebody who signed up for the Adventurers Guild and I'm just trying to get my name known. I had some weird little vision thing on while I was on the boat to get to here. But other than that, I'm nobody special. Nim, what are you doing? Stop pulling up the carpet. All right, picking oranges. Okay, investigating the Sea Song Grotto is MSQ. We'll go up there first. Because that is my Marauder quest, and there should be a bridge over here. Thank you. That was mine. Alright, now we'll go to the Susan Grotto. Nim, what are you doing? Bring you down a little bit because you're high for where I'm used to going. Target status info and my status info. Save. Nim, I know you want to go out there, but Leia's being grumpy. God, you're going to pull the carpet up, though. One second. Is Leia on the other side? Hmm? Will you two be nice to each other? Will you calm down, Leia? Okay. I think the moment has passed. Come here, baby girl. Oi. Think this is where I meet Stola. Kill these. I know I'll probably kill more. All right, the stone monument. You're about to enter an instance dungeon. Yeah, I know what these are. Level 9, I'm 11.
I am the waves that bear. I am the winds that guide. I am the evening stars. I am the morning sky. I am born of the sea, and there shall I die. Thus reads the sailor's requiem, carved into yonder stone. Such words well describe the manner in which the citizens of Limsa Luminsa live their lives. It is both a litany against misfortune for those out on the waves, and a prayer that the souls of those who perish on land might find their way back to the sea. Ah, you are the adventurer I've seen around Summerford Farms. I thought myself on the trail of the kidnappers, but it would seem I have missed my mark.
Goo-boo.
Or perhaps not. As I suspected, the etheric disturbance here is no natural occurrence. Nor is it a coincidence that the two of us should come here in search of those responsible for the disappearances, only to be attacked. But who stands to benefit from the keeping of this secret?
I'll click once I can see again. Leia, I'm not playing the cat butt game. Please find a place to lie down. Please find a place to lie down. You can lie down in front of my computer monitor. I can see then. It's just when you stand. Where are you gonna lie down? That's a perfect spot. Don't worry about the costume jewelry. Leia, what do you need, girl? Huh? What do you need? I would very much like to play my game, girl, but you're in the way. Would you like to play with my hair tie? No.
Oh, such thoughts must wait. Let us attend to the task at hand, unpleasant though it be.
I can do this with only seeing 3/4 of my screen. Just don't move, girl. Don't worry. I'm not gonna heal myself. Oh, more. I wish I had my overpower. So slow. Woohoo! First duty done. Haha, my crystal. I miss these scenes.
Feel. Think.
crystal bearer. I am Hydaelyn, all made one. A light there once was that shone throughout this realm, yet it hath since grown dim. And as it hath faltered, so hath darkness risen up in its stead, presaging an end to life. For the sake of all, I beseech thee, deliver us from this fate. The power to banish the darkness dwelleth in the crystals of light. Journey forth and lay claim to them. By thy deeds shall the crystals reveal themselves to thee. Only believe, for the light liveth in thy heart. Shine thy light on all creation.
Awake again, are we? Aha! The poor creature's fury was kindled with cruel forethought. See this blade? I found it in the Gubu's back.
Stole out your shoes. Your shoes.
I have seen knives of this kind before. They are most commonly used for the cutting of rope. It would appear our culprits are seafaring men of some persuasion, piratical being the most probable. In any event, you seem much recovered from your sudden affliction. I confess, I was rather taken aback when you collapsed at the very moment of our victory. Mayhap a surfeit of ether? I beg your pardon. A towering crystal. I'm sure I don't. Oh! Well, well. This has been a day of unexpected revelations. I must continue my investigation. In the meantime, I suggest you deliver this knife to your patron, along with a warning concerning the pirate's probable involvement in this murky business. The days ahead promise little rest, I fear.
And then there will come a time everybody tells me to rest.
May our paths cross again. Under the light of the crystal.
Is everybody on Zalera a marauder? In inquiring minds want to know. Whereas everybody who has decided to do exactly the same thing I'm doing chosen Zalera. Look at the luscious oranges brimming with nectar. They could drop any second. Here's some. Ah, ripe to perfection. How sweet it is. If the lackadaisical lot of retired pirates comes down with scurry, it'd serve them right. It just goes to show you, you can't teach an old sea dog new tricks. You'd think the Admiral would know that. Lenotian orange nectar is sweet, but rest assured it's paid for in sweat. We have to pollinate each orange by hand because of the blasted pucks that prey on the nearby bees. If we could only eradicate some 5 puck hatchlings, it could save us from having to do nature's work. Got it. Turn in the other side quest before I talk to him. Where? There we go. I chopped your blocks. You've certainly proven you're not one to let obstacles stand in your path. If only these supposedly pioneering pirates were half as industrious as you. Expanding borders is all well and good, but the Admiral ought to know rugged frontiers can't be settled by layabouts. Where are the puck hatchlings? All the way down there. Okay, let's go ahead and talk to MSQ guy, and then we'll go get the pucks. Fairheart, right glad I am to see you safely returned. My lads were all gabbing about here in what sounded like all 7 hells breaking loose near the grotto, and I'd feared I'd sent you to your death. If you were in the middle of that commotion, I hope it yielded something of interest. I'd hate to think you'd risk your life for naught. Oh, it was definitely interesting. I met this cat, and I talked to this crystal. A blade pulled from the back of a creature you slew at the cave, eh? I had agreed that such a knife would be part of any seafaring man's kit. I'm starting to think that these ruffians are pirates come to lure my farmhands back to a life of plunder. Chances are they didn't take kindly to your appearance on their doorstep and sent Madden Gooboo after you. Aye, the pirates have been adding to their numbers of late. I'd best warn the lads and lasses in my employ to be on guard against their schemes. You met someone else at the grotto? A woman with a strange contraption? Ah, Ishtola. She's been in Limsa Lominsa for a good while now. Her studies of the Aether often bring her out to Summerford, so her presence at the grotto is hardly unusual. She's an odd-looking lass, I grant you, especially those damn shoes. But she's not the kind to associate with kidnappers. You may take my word for that. Where trust should be lacking is in those yeomen of mine who have yet to wholly relinquish their pirate pasts. The temptation to return to the free and easy life of a buccaneer may prove too strong to resist. You have my thanks, Fairheart. If it weren't for the efforts of stalwart adventurers like yourself, this farm would be in far worse state than it is. Just you keep on lending your talents to those in need, eh? Help bring Limsa the bright future she deserves. That Sleeth Sloth Severin and his lot never around when there's work to be done. I'd sooner hire you for the sake of getting things done, but then the rapscallions would never learn. Round them up and let them know that Stelwyn would like a word. And don't take no for an answer. Oh, there's one. You're an MSQ, but you're not the MSQ, I think. Blast, how's a botanist supposed to accomplish field work without a field to work in? Washed up pirates are well and good when you want a field pillaged and plundered, but not when you need it plowed. Who has that piece? A lone horticulturist such as myself hardly strikes fear in the hearts of monsters, but your gait is such that I believe you might. I'd be much obliged if you could rid the field of some mandragoras. With 5 fewer of the sprouting critters roaming about, I'm sure I could return to my field. My work. Yes, 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 yes. Everybody wants me to kill things for them. That's what I'm here for. Okay. What am I missing? Well, let's go do the other stuff first, and then we'll worry about finding what I'm missing here. Hey, it's Severin. Hi, I'm Severin. You the old man's errand boy now? Tell my dear old captain not to wet his brushes. I'll be along. Oh, and just for so we're clear, I don't care for landlubbers. Go find the chocobo you rode in on and ride on out. I don't have a chocobo yet. Thank you. So, Stalwarden sent you. And what do you recognize to say to that? Workers for the weak and litless? I've saucier seeds to sow. Damn right, didn't get where I am by taking guff from any glorified gardeners, but I suppose I could see what he wants to get him off my back. Two down. Axes were made for splitting skulls, not stumps. You know what I did in my sailing days? You bet your beard I did, lad. Those were the days. I reckon now I'll have to be satisfied taking my axe to the trees. Find these other two. One whom I was already having a difficult time finding. Ugh, how am I supposed to work on an empty stomach? Go on, have a guess at what I had for breakfast. Ash tuna. Breaded sticks. How did you know? It's my breath, ain't it? Probably smells as wooden as the food tasted. But I know why you're here. I'd just as soon get some real food in me, but I ain't one to reject a summons from the captain. Off you go now. Can I get around on the outside here? Because something tells me that's where the fifth one is. Nope. I can't go around that way. Denied. Work? Ha! Can't work when me hands are full lifting this mug. You know I'd wager me last gill. You'd never guess what I'm drinking. Swill wine? Well, you're right about the swill part. I reckon it might be worth a day of doing Star Wars chores that can force me a taste of proper grog. Yes, people. Go get paid. Stop moping about. Buzz on the winds tells me you've done the deed. The only pests plaguing my orchard are those woeful whelps out of water. If only you could rid me of the parasitic pirates as you did the pesky pucks. How about that? You've already done more than the whole lot of slothful sea slugs combined. If only they'd spent half as much time proving their worth as they do talking about it. You continue to impress, lad. All but Severin are accounted for. It's no fault of yours, he squirmed out. I've let that worm wriggle through my fingers more times than I can count. But rest assured, the next time I see him, I'll put him squarely in the dirt, where all such worms belong. Pains me to say, but all the guild in the world can't buy loyalty. There are some, like you, who can be trusted. But then there are others. Until now, I've had no choice but to rely on that charlatan Severin, even though I am full aware he's been doing shady deals behind my back. More than once, I've heard him tell of improper trading with goblins. I wouldn't be the least surprised if that were happening right now. Not a bell ago, a sack of oranges vanished. As did Severin. I want you to find and confront the bastard for me, Fairheart. I'm sure there's wrongdoing afoot, so be sure to doubt anything that comes out of his mouth. I want a chocobo. I want a chocobo. Bloody hells. I'm up the strait without a paddle. What's this now? Stalwarn sent you for the oranges? Huh? So the odd bugger had known all this time. What does it matter anyway? Listen, you're one of those goody-goody adventurer types, right? Go rescue me mates from those double-dealing goblins. They're just over yonder by the bonfire. I owe you one. Wouldn't have gotten away myself if not for Severin shoving me aside. Would have gotten away myself if not for Severin shoving me aside. Severin sent you? Ha! The way he flew out of here, I was sure he sold us down the river. If you hadn't come, my dodo would have been cooked! Cooked dodo. You saved me mates, and for that, I owe ya. Suppose I should be ashamed I couldn't clean up my own mess. But a pirate knows no shame. I've no qualms about going back on my word. I've only given you this sack because I like the cut of your jib. Take to Austin and send him my regards. More and more travelers pass through these gates bloodied and bruised each day. They tell me the Yarzans harry them at the Rogue. It pains me to do nothing, but we need every man we have just to hold the garrison. You would do us all a great service were you to thin the Yarzan population for us. If you could clear out, say, three of their nest, we'd be in your debt. Yeah. Although I'd like kill quests better than fetch quests. What have we here? A delivery from Summerford Farms and is scheduled? Ha! There's our first time for everything. Well, look at that. Not a single one missing either. About the only things not here are those bagmen, and I don't miss them one bit. Here's Stalwart's payment in full. With you, I can trust it'll reach him. Kill the Arzen. Ah, so you did for the Vilekin. Ever passer through owes you a debt of gratitude. Lethagrin is a vital stronghold, one the Maelstrom would defend themselves had they the means. The fleet is spread too thin, which is why the Yellowjackets have been called in. But our numbers are hardly inexhaustible, and your help goes a long way towards preserving the peace. Ugly, ugly, ugly colors. Back in one piece, that's a relief. How did you fare, Fairheart? Ah, this is what I was aiming for. Looks to be all I was owed, all right. Though I'd be telling you false if I claimed I had not held out more hope for Severin. I was even willing to overlook the skimming off the top, but to sell us all short in favor of those godforsaken goblins. You'd do well to mind yourself around the two guilt cheat. If he'd leave his own mates for dead, there's no telling what he'd do to you. Alas, at this rate, the crops will never be ready for harvest. If only we had black loam, just a bit could send our stock soaring. I bet Rotwida knows where you might find some. Perhaps you might pay her a visit in the orchard. If you're heading to Tiller's Rest, am I? I don't think so. I have a favor to ask of you. The pirates have been away from sea for too long, and their broken hearts turn to bloodshed for solace. A full supply of medicine lasts barely a week. If you could buy a high potion and take it up to Wildorf, we might be able to save some lives. I have a high potion. Yay me. The Kirkhan's got a hat of cabbage if he thinks I'm fetching any black loam. But if you dare to pinch some from the cook pot, well, then be my guest. Just mind you don't get trampled upon by the oryx that dwell there. Once you've 3 bushels worth, take the black loam to Prifwell at Tiller's Rest. He'll know what to do. Oh, okay. I'm on my way to Tiller's Rest anyway. Let's go up this way. How much I ran around this place. Fate grinding. Come here. Come here. Captain Peter Pigeon-Toe. Come here. No, I'm not doing this fate. Oh, I'm definitely not doing this fate. Run! Run, Gale! Now to Tiller's Rest. I'm plumb out of potion. Any sorry sufferer knocking on my door may well as be knocking on Thal's. All's I can do is offer him a prayer. Were I a gods-fearing man, I'd say you were heaven sent. After the dust settles from the next pirate brawl, some sorry soul will owe you his lousy life. I pity the poor fish out of water. At first, I thought the fights were just to kill time, but now I believe some truly have a death wish. There's naught that can be done about that. We can't make them want to live. All we can do is hope they learn to love the land. A belt! Even the weeds wither and die in the desolate dirt. But a bit of this black loam ought to change all that. I haven't seen any in ages. Gathering black loam's not for the weak of will, nor the weak of stomach, eh? Oh, don't tell me Gurkant and Rotwitta neglected to mention where black loam comes from. Well, surely you figured it out on your own from the cloyn stench. It comes from the Auroch's lair, of all places. Well, why dwell on who misled whom about what? What matters is that your efforts have brought us this black loam, and we can expect a bountiful harvest as a result. Thank you. Take your manure. Level 5, level 8... Why is it all hideous colors? Confounded pirates, they know nothing of tillin', only killin'. Stealin' our shovels to melt and forge into axes of all things. They're biting the hand that feeds them, the mangy mongrels. I'd love to teach those curs a lesson in obedience myself, if I hadn't sworn to Stowa that I wouldn't fight no more. So, I need you to bring back our farm tools and make sure those dogs reap what they've sown. Okay, I'll do you instead. I wonder what those sea dogs will try and steal when there's no harvest. Ah, good to see the tools back and in serviceable condition, which will be more than we can say of Severin when we get our hands on him. The wretch likely had a role in the theft. Spied him meeting the pirates in secret, I did. Couldn't care less if that wastrel won't work. But when he consorts with the cat purses that take our tools away, he's crossed the line. Still, we're not to know what sort of scallywag he's dealing with. Take word to him, would you? Okay, this time I'm just going to teleport. Because I don't have a chocobo! I think I'm only going to play for another 50 more minutes because I'm tired. Pirates making off with their tools. Prifwald did well not to take matters into his own hands. Last thing I need is blood on my crops. But I'll be damned if Severin thinks he can take us for fools. His treachery won't go unpunished. I have no memory of putting that on, or knowing that it gave me an XP bonus, but it doesn't give me a bonus anymore. One mind. 8, 5. What was that? 11. I don't care. 9, 6. Yeah, no. I'm over 10. It doesn't matter. I've come to expect a great deal from you, lad, and you've never once let me down. Yet, what I'd ask of you now goes beyond aught I've asked before. Would you hear my plea all the same? It eases my mind to have your ear. You're no doubt familiar with that scoundrel Severn by now. Well, the scheming scapegoat is at it again. Since that letter came for him, he's been skulking about in that manner he does when he's up to no good. Now he's rounded up his rogues and buggered off with nary a word to anyone. I've grown accustomed to his insolence, but something tells me this is different. It ain't exactly damning, but when last I had words with him, he didn't look defiant so much as hunted. I can't help thinking he's gone looking for trouble and found more than he wanted. So I was hoping you might hunt his sorry hide down and drag it back here before it's too late. The ungrateful little cur bites me every chance he gets, but I can't quite bring myself to cut him loose. I suppose he reminds me a bit of my younger self. Suffice it to say, I'd rather he didn't come to a sticky end. As for how to find him, I'd try asking Grinwitta at the Aetherite. She was the last one to see him. I dare say she'll be able to tell you where he's headed. Nothing that passes through those gates escapes my notice. I saw the Rouser and his rabble set out for Woad Whisper Canyon not long ago, singing about drinking themselves stupider. Cheeky sod said I should join them. I told them I'd rather shrivel up than sip whatever it was that had pickled their brains. If you find the idle swine, be sure and give them a cuff round the ear for me, will you? What level is 9? Okay. Okay, we're getting closer. I know where I'm going, but I'm just double checking. Yep. Run, Gale, run. In a completely unembarrassing way. How do I run with my weapon drawn? How do I sprint? I almost want to say the girl sprints better. Your arms are too wide. You have a better jog, she has a better sprint. Of all the dirty, deceitful, downright dastardly deeds that slippery bastard's done. Claiming to take the lads out for a drink, only to lead us straight into a bloody trap. Don't get no lower than that. Of course, I've learned to stay a step ahead of old Severin, so I was ready, but the others weren't so lucky. You've got to help them. My axe may as well have been a white flag for all the good it did. Hope you fare better, or the sorry bastards in there are done for. Severin might have got us into this mess, but I ain't about to let him give his life for us. I'd sooner bow to a fishback than be in the conniving bastard's debt. To arms! A true knave. You betray even yourself, Severin. Ugh. We were prepared to overlook the manner of your desertion on the condition that you provided us with suitable replacements. That was the agreement. Yet your latest change of heart leaves your debt to us unpaid. That's a man? Tattooed man. Those are definitely boobs. Few are they who betray the Serpent Reavers twice. You will not do so a third time. Cowering behind your protector will only delay the inevitable. Honorless wretch, your life is all you have left. And worthless though it may be, we shall take it. O mournful voice of creation, send unto me a creature of the abyss, my thrall to command, that I may smite mine enemies. that the golem could be vanquished. That man is no ordinary adventurer. Bring on the Ascians. The snake slithered away. I am only glad he did not have the chance to sink his fangs more deeply into you. I was barely touched. Ooh! Echo? Those pirates do not belong to any of the known Lumensan factions. Whom do they serve? The Beast Tribes? Surely not. But the timing of their appearance coincides all too neatly with the certain recent surge in Sahagin and Kobold activity. Something is afoot. The question is, what? Could it be that the tribes are planning to summon their primals? 12 help us if it should prove so. Limsa would be hard-pressed to keep a single primal at bay, let alone two. But all is yet speculation. I must needs find evidence. The seas continue to rise. There is no reason for this to be here, because her getting the inclination to visit me is 5 years after this falls. And ilm by ilm, the world becomes ever more unlike itself. It is as Louis-Soi foretold. The coming of chaos has rendered the laws of nature mutable, blurring the boundary between the material and aether planes. Little now stands between us and the primals. Unless this was all happening before the calamity, but why would it? But they are not here yet. Though time be against us, hope shall ever be on our side. Never did the creed of Charlian ring more true. Never did I dream that I would possess the means to see Aether. Oh, Shtola. Yet now that I do begin to take it for granted. How swiftly do the wonders of Charlian seem commonplace. Here, for you. Have you come for the festivities? Today, the Maelstrom officially makes the Great Hole in the Sea its training ground. Join in the celebrations. Wait, a disturbance in the aetheric flow? But whence does it emanate? Seasong Grotto, perhaps? See, if that's when she runs to meet me, like, 5 minutes ago, then there's no reason for Dalaman to be falling from the sky. Still doesn't make any sense. What have we here? Can you walk? Tis I. Regrettably, no, he eluded me. Understood. I will inform the Commodore. You collapsed from your exertions. Are you suitably recovered? Severin here has apprised me of all that transpired. His account sheds some light upon how you came to be attacked by a golem of all things. A golem is a mindless automaton, inert save when commanded to be otherwise. Common pirates could not hope to control such a thing, so arcane are its workings. But then, these tattooed wretches are no common pirates. They are the minions of the Sahagin. As to their purpose, well, I shall get to the bottom of it. But first, I must escort Severin back to his place of employment. I dare say Stalhorn will be wondering what has become of him. And you too, for that matter. I will bear word to him of your preservation, but I am certain he would like to thank you in person. Pray pay the man a visit. Ah, he told me of you, but perchance he did not tell you of me. My name is Yshtola. I am a naturalist of sorts, surveying the aether in the hope that it might offer up some clue as to our predicament. I'd say I owed you my life, but that don't cover it. If it weren't for you, my friends would be dead and all. 'Tis a debt I can never repay, but I'll not make things worse by running away. Take me to Summerford Farms, and I'll face the consequences. For reasons I cannot fathom, you seem... Forgive me. Mayhap we will have a chance to speak again when I have marshaled my thoughts. Until our paths next cross, farewell. Lo, I knew you'd return. Yshtola delivered Severin a bit ago. Tales of your heroic deeds precede you. The rest came shuffling back too, the lot of them sporting the same haunted expression. It's me who's to blame for that. That and the rest. I was once a serpent reaver. A thrall to the Sahagin. Seven hells. Reavers may look and sound and act like pirates, but they're not but the fishback's flunkies. Us pirates ain't much for laws, but there's things we won't do. We've got a code, see? But the Reavers never followed a word of it. A few years back, they started snatching law-abiding Lominsons. I'd only just taken my oath when our captain bent the knee to his new Sahagin masters. I knew I had to get away. So I crept off one night, got myself a new name, and found myself a new home, Summerford Farms. Trouble is, secrets don't say secret for long round here, and word soon spread all the way back to the sea. The penalty for desertion is death, but the Reavers offered me a way out instead. My freedom in exchange for my mates. The letter? I don't know what I was thinking. I wasn't bloody thinking. Too busy solling meself. Spoiling myself. Aye, but you got there in the end, didn't you? When the time came, you made the right decision. The men say little to me, but I hear them talk of how you stood up to the Reavers at the last, of how you tried to give your life to save theirs. Be that as it may, no deed, however good, can atone for the crime of betraying your brethren. I know that. I do. That's why I'm going to hand myself over to the Yellow Jackets. I'll bring shame to the farm no more. You'll hear no arguments from me. Each man must sail according to his own moral compass. I just hope yours guides you back here someday. There will always be a place for you at Summerford Farms, lad. And I'll always be in your debt, Stillborn. I owe you a debt too, Gale, but not once have you let me down. Thank you for saving the men of my farm. If I could ask one more favor of you, it'd be this. Tell Batarin what's happened, from start to finish. I'm certain he'd put in a good word for Severin if he knew the whole story. And he's one of the few people I know who the Yellow Jackets will listen to. Well, I reckon I've asked all I possibly can of you. Safe travels, son. And we can head back. And I'll clear these quests, pick up my next two, and call it a night. Once again, your capacity for carnage has been tested and proven. The creatures you defeated, however, were merely some of the many base scavengers that subsist on the scraps left in the wake of Kujata's rampages. To face Kujata himself, you yet require far more training. But do not despair, Gale. As Axemaster and fellow marauder, this I swear, I will not rest until I have taught you how to wring every last ounce of power from your weapon until the blade of your axe can slice cleanly through the thickest hide, the most knotted muscle, the densest bone. This menace will fall by your hand. You may find yourself drawn to explore the possibilities offered by other disciplines and guilds. These distractions are inevitable and perhaps necessary. This would normally probably be when you would tell me to go do my complimentary one, but I don't think we need to do that anymore. But I urge you to soon return to the path of the Marauder. I do not wish your edge to dull just as you begin to show potential. Fare you well, Gale. Blah, blah, blah. Let's do that. Gear sets have been added. Woohoo! Okay. FFXIV strength, dexterity. Yeah, this is better, even though it goes down by two. And next one's 15. Almost there. All right, let's go to Bateron. And turn this in, and then we'll call it a night, because I can't stop yawning. Thank you. Bloody hells, life on the farm ain't quite how I pictured it. Ah, but you needn't worry yourself over young Severin. The Yellow Jackets has hands out... The Yellow Jackets has hands out the punishments as a good mate of mine. If I ask him nice, I reckon he'd be willing to commute the lad's sentence from Agen to Neil Holland, kindly gent that he is. Ah, I'm only jesting with you. I'll see he's treated fair. Now, it sounds to me like you've done everything old Stalwart asked of you and more, justifying me generous finder's fee in the process. Much obliged, lad. As for a reward, well, she's a lonely lad, this drowning wench of mine. How'd you fancy keeping her company for a spell? With free room and board. Venturing's a trying business after... Oh, that's what I can do? I can log out in an inn every time. Venturing's of trying business after all. Them as don't rest their bones every now and again tend to up with broken ones. I can't talk, I gotta go to bed. And take it from me, fighting ain't nearly so much fun when you're nursing a shattered arm. Got that? Good. There'll always be a free bed for ye, so make use of it. Now that you'll have much more time... Not that you'll have much more time for laying around, what with all the leaves you'll be doing. Oh, didn't I mention? I'm putting your name down for leaves. Our guild draws all manner of clients, offering all manner of odd jobs. Honestly, you'd be amazed how much folk will pay to avoid doing an honest day's labor. I know, that's what Warrior of Light does. Just ask Timokri a shout whenever you feel like making a few extra gil. She'll always have some task or other for you to do. Oh, and it's all above board, case you're wondering. We're careful to stay on the Admiral's right side and ear, unlike some pirates I can mention. I tell ya, if it turns out they had aught to do with them kidnappings, there'll be seven hells to pay. A proper bleeding reckoning. Mayhap that's what Limsa needs, though. Our rough seas. On rough seas, sometimes you have to rock the boat to right it. But we'll have... time for such talk when you're well and rested. Till then, enjoy the wench's hospitality. Alright, so we will actually go to the inn and fall asleep there. And call that a night. Because I could go to my own inn bedroom. Alright, so... change my camera angle, come around this. And bid everyone farewell for tonight. Don't look so serious, Gale. You're going to bed too. So, Wednesday will be House Slipper. Next Saturday, we will continue this journey. Talk to Bateron and see who our next patron is going to be. And maybe we'll learn more about the mysterious mage in black and this Yestola person. And what's with these crystals? And this crystal telling us to collect more crystals. So much more to be discovered. Such a guy.